Hello, welcome to Basics of Finite Element Analysis Part 2. This is the fifth week of this course and today is the third lecture. And in the last lecture, we were developing the weak formulation for a two-dimensional single variable problem. And we will continue that discussion today. And once we are done with developing the weak formulation, then we will introduce approximation functions in the weak formulation to develop finite element equations at an element level. What we had discussed in the last class was that we had developed this particular equation, equation F, and in context of equation F, we said that U is the primary variable. So, in the boundary terms, we get W, which corresponds to knowledge of U. If it is known, then the variation of U is 0. So, U is the primary variable, and if we specify it, then it is an essential boundary condition. And then there is also a longish boundary term, which we can abbreviate as Qn, that is the essential boundary condition. So, with that, what we will do is we will rewrite this equation. So, this is Wx A11 ux plus A12 uy plus wy A21 ux plus A22 uy plus A00 wu. So, this is a surface integral and this equals Wf dx dy plus boundary integral of Wqn ds, okay, where Qn we had defined in the last class here, right? This entire thing is Qn. So, Qn equals A11 ux plus A12 uy nx plus A21 ux plus A22 uy ny. So, let us call this equation 1. So, I can rewrite equation 1 as b, some function b or functional b of w and u equals another functional of Lw, and I will explain this in a moment. So, B of W and U is this entire thing. So, this equals so, that is my B of W and U. And then this L, which depends on W, is W F dx dy plus W Q n ds. Now, couple of these things. First thing, B of W and U is bilinear. If A11, A12, A21, A22, A00 do not depend on U. It is bilinear. Bilinear in U, okay, and also in W. It is bilinear in U and W. If A11, A22, all these things, one of them depend on U, then it will not be bilinear. Because then when we plug in the value of A11, there will be U square and terms like that. So then it will no longer be bilinear. Also, it is symmetric in U and W if A21 equals A12. So, if these terms are equal, then if you replace W with U, U and W, then you will still get the same result. Okay. So, if these terms are, then it will be symmetric, but by default it is not symmetric. By default it is not symmetric, but it is definitely bilinear. It is bilinear if these conditions hold, if it is symmetric if these conditions hold. Okay. And a lot of times we write it as B dot comma dot if it is symmetric. If it is symmetric, then we write it as in this form. Because, so with this understanding, now what we will do is, so we have developed the weak formulation. And then what is the next step? So what we found was that first thing is we discretize, we do the weak form. And then we plug in the approximation functions for the system. So we have seen that the weak formulation, when we do the weak formulation, a surface integral, it also yields some boundary terms. So it yields some surface integral terms and also some boundary integral terms. Okay. So at this stage, so that was, and the nature of this integration was different than what we did was in case of one dimensional problems. So, next thing we will do is develop finite element equations. So, we will develop finite element equations at element level. Okay. So, this is my overall equation and I have to convert this into element level equation. So, what do? We first approximate U as, we assume U as some approximation function, and what we do is that we say, okay, U for eth element which can vary with respect to x and y equals uj e psi j xy j is equal to 1 to n, where uj is value of u at jth node in eth element. Okay. And then psi j is interpolation function it is interpolation function. associated with jth node. Associated with jth node. So if there are n nodes and n number of nodes. So if I have a triangle I have three nodes 1, 2, 3. How many interpolation functions will be there in this case? 3, right? So psi 1 x y will be an interpolation function associated with first node, psi 2 x y will be an interpolation function associated with second node, psi 3 x y will be interpolation function associated with the third node. Understood? Let us say that these values are, the coordinates are x 1 and y 1. Coordinates of the nodes. These are global coordinates. So, this is x 2, y 2 and this is x 3, y 3. So, these are three different nodes. First node has coordinates x 1, y 1. These are global coordinates. Second node has coordinates x 2, y 2. Third node has coordinates x 3, y 3. Okay. So in that case, psi 1, x 1, y 1, and we will see why this comes out, but at this point of time, we will just take it at its face value. So what will be the value of psi 1 at x 1, y 1? In one dimensional equation, in one dimensional element, this is node 1, this is node 2. And we had psi 1 and psi 2. The value of psi 1 was what at first node? 1. And the value of psi 1 at second node was 0. Value of psi 2 at first node was 0 and psi 2 at first second node was 1. Similarly, the value of psi 1 at first node will be 1. Psi 1 at x 2 y 2 will be 0 and psi 1 at x 3 y 3 will be 0. Okay. Psi 2 x 1 y 1 will be 0, psi 2 at second node will be 1. And psi 2 at third node will be 0. Psi 3 at x 1, y 1 first node will be 0. Psi 3 at second node will be 0. And psi 3 at third node will be 0. Oh, sorry, 1. So, I can generalize this by saying that the value of psi I for eth element at node, at jth node is Kronecker delta I j. So, this is equal to value of psi associated with ith node evaluated at jth node. Understood? What is Kronecker delta? So, Kronecker delta, you must have read earlier that Kronecker delta is equal to 1 when I equals j, and it is equal to 0 when I is not equal to j. Okay. So, likewise, we can also develop similar approximation functions for a rectangle. It will have 4 nodes. There we will have psi 1, psi 2, psi 3, psi 4, and same thinking continues. I could have a 6 noded element, triangle element, and same thinking will get extended. So this is my approximation function, and this approximation function I have to plug it in this equation 1. Okay. So, I will call this equation 2. This is equation 1. So, we plug 2 in 1, plug 2 in 1 to get So, once we plug equation 2 into 1, this is, let us call this equation 3, this is the long equation which we get. And this represents the weak form of the weighted residual statement. Now, in equation 3, A1 is known, A12 is known, all A's are known. These are some things which we know, right? These relate to material property. Also psi j's, which are approximation functions, we will develop them. So, we know these functions, right? The only thing we do not know, also w is a weight function. So, when we assign a weight to something, we have to know what weight we are assigning. So, w is known. The only things which we do not know, so this first thing is that this is added over j is equal to 1 to n. Yeah. So, the only thing which we do not know is in this equation is what? U. Uj is not known. And how many uj's are there? This is being added over and so total unknown uj's are n. So this is one equation and we have unknowns. So we cannot solve this equation, right? So what do? We have to generate n equations, and this is at element level. So we have to generate n equations at the element level. And how do we generate n equations? So we have to have n equations to solve for n uj's. So what do? For this, we use n different weight functions. Okay. We use n different weight functions. So if I have n different weight functions, so in first case I will use W1 and write down equation 3. In another case I will have W2 and write down equation 3, and so on and so forth. So what I do is, instead of W, I replace it by WI. Okay. So the moment I replace W by WI, and I is equal to 1 to n, I is equal to 1 to n, then equation 3 represents how many equations? N equations. So I equals 1 to n. So now we have n equations and n unknowns, n equations and n unknowns. Now in variational formulation, we had seen in part 1 also that essentially what we do is that WI, we say, is same as psi I XY. This is what we exactly did in one dimensional thing also. So this is again same thing. So in that case, my equation, so equation 3 becomes so now what I will do is I will take uj out of the differentiation term, because uj is a constant. So when I differentiate it, it will give 0. So I can take it out. So this is equal to j equals 1 to n plus psi I psi j So that's equation 4. So these are n equations. And uj is unknown. I can also express this equation. So these are n equations, so I can also express this equation in a matrix form k for the eth element equals u for the eth element equals a vector for the eth element. And here k I j for the eth element equals integral over the domain of the element of this entire thing a 11 psi I partial with respect to x plus a 12 del psi I over del x del psi j over del y plus a 21 del psi I over del y del psi j over del x plus a 22 del psi I over del y, del psi j over del y plus a 00 psi I psi j dx dy. And then f I for the eth equation equals integral of f times psi I dx dy plus q n psi I ds. This is a boundary integral. Now, earlier we had said that this expression B is bilinear and it will be symmetric in U and W if A 21 equals A 12. This is what we had said. Now you please look here. This matrix, this K matrix will be symmetric if A 12 and A 21 are same, then K I j will be same as K j I. So, K I j equals K j I if A 12 equals A 21. So, in a lot of physical problems, A 12 and A 21 is indeed the same entity. So, in those problems K I j equals K j I, which means K is a symmetric matrix, and that makes things a little bit easy when we are trying to solve the problems. And the F vector, I can also write it as F I plus Q I. I should have, actually I will make a small correction, I will call this Q and I will erase this. So, the F vector depends only on F, and then the Q I is the boundary term which is psi I Q n d s integrated over the boundary of the element. Okay. So, these are the finite element equations. So, these are the finite element equations, and what we will do is we will close the discussion for today. In the next class, what we will do is we will develop these interpolation functions, because right now we do not know what is the nature of these interpolation functions. So, in next couple of classes we will develop these functions. So, thanks a lot, and we will meet tomorrow. Thank you.